I'm talking on the surgeries for the clavicle fracture. 1 year back, I have treated 30-year-old man with clavicle fracture and scapula fracture and rib fracture. It's a floating shoulder. He was treated conservatively by me. After one year, he visited me recently, and this was his finding. His main complaint was he was unable to perform the upper limb workout, and he has obvious drooping of the shoulder as compared to the normal side. And when I took the x-ray, this was his x-ray finding, showing the clear-cut non-in of the clavicle. His outcome would have been definitely better if I have fixed the fracture clavicle by surgery. So we all know all clavicle fracture unites simply with cuff and collar. But union does not mean good results. Symptomatic malunion and non-union are the main issues of the conservative treatment. Malunited clavicle fracture leads to change in the orientation of the glenoid that results in the scapular winging. Shortening of the clavicle leads to shortening of the muscles, resulting in the weakness. Both these things leads to change in the shoulder kinematics. If you review the literature, we will find the exact outcome of the conservative treatment. Decades together, we have followed the Nears myth that the non-union are very rare. In 1960, Near et al. Studied 2,235 cases presented with only non-union rate as less as 0.1%, and later Rowe also seconded the same study by giving the non-union rate as 0.8%. After these studies, decades together, the clavicle fracture were treated conservatively. But the newer papers have shown that the outcome of a non-operative management of the displaced middle clavicle fracture is not as good as traditionally thought. Here et al. Found that non-union rate is as high as up to 15%. And unsatisfactory results in many patients more than 30%. Again, in a study of a meta-analysis of the cases from 1975 to 2005 of conservative, intramedullary and plate fixation of the displaced middle clavicle fracture have shown the same non-union as Hill has shown that. In randomized control trial, the non-union rate was again the same, that is around 15%. In a landmark study done by Thompson, he reviewed the 100 non-union cases of a displaced clavicle fracture treated by conservative treatment. He found that more than 90% cases were associated with the shortening, complete displacement and comminution. He found that there is a strong correlation between these two findings. So what are the indications for the surgery? So if the displacement is more than 2 cm, if the shortening is more than 2 cm, if the fracture is open or impending compound fracture, or in a patient with floating shoulder, that is with fracture of the clavicle and fracture of the glenoid neck, then established non-union cases, there is a strong indication for the surgical fixation of the clavicular fractures. So how do you fix it? So there are large variety of implants starting from K-wires, pins, screws, XPs has been studied extensively in past. But the commonly used implants are anatomical plates, thick pelvic reconstruction plates and intramedullary titanium nails. So in each modality of treatment, there are a lot of studies, but at the end, the nailing are better in stable fracture with good intramedullary canal, and the plates are much superior in unstable fracture and which are biomechanically more stronger than intramedullary nails. So while doing nailing, as you know, the clavicle is S-shaped, having different canal in different parts of the clavicle. Ideally, the entry is taken 1 cm middle to the middle end of the clavicle, and it is drilled with a drill bit and gradually widened in the direction of the canal. Adequate size titanium elastic nail is passed closely under fluoroscopic control, and it is nivelled across the distal fragment. Sometimes you require a mini open reduction or use of pointed reduction clamps also. Clavicle plates can be done in two ways. One is a superior approach, another is an anterior approach. The superior approach is more commonly done, which is biomechanically more stable, and it is very favorable approach to all the surgeon, but it has chances of iatrogenic injury to neurovascular structures and also the